Hi, thank you for watching. Good morning. Today I'm sharing with you a project that I finished. I did share the front part of this on my Instagram account, which I will link below. But I'm done now. At first it was only the front part, and I just so excited about this little window that I made that I had to share it before it was even finished. So I literally just shared this part, but look how cool. So I'll explain a little bit about how I did this. It's not very difficult at all. I added these little dangly bits right here on the side. I wanted to make a flip book. I initially didn't want to use these rings, but this was the first one of these I made. I feel like I say that all the time when I'm showing you guys videos, but honestly, I'm still quite new at crafting, and a lot of this stuff is my first one. So I'm learning as I go. I just made another one of these that I cannot share with you because it's for something else that I'm not able to share it with you yet. But I will. I'll definitely share it because I love it. I think it's my favorite thing so far that I've ever made. So for this window, I used nesting dies. I got these heart nesting dies from AliExpress, and I pretty much, these are just sheets. I think I got these sheets to store my stamps in, but I don't ever use my stamps, so I don't use these sheets. But the trickiest part about this is when you're making this outline with this heart, you have to make sure, I made sure I used one of the sides of this that was already sealed. So when you cut it, you don't have two loose pieces of plastic, because that's really hard to keep together to get an even stitch around it. And then I stitched very carefully around the heart so I could lock that side in. If you don't have a sewing machine, just use your fuse tool. If you don't have a fuse tool, I'm not sure how you would do it, but and then I stitched around here. Like I said, it's really important that you have a base, because it's hard to get an even stitch with the layers if you don't have a locking point. So make sure one of the sides is sealed. So this side was already sealed, and then I did the heart, then I stitched the heart, then I did the outside. So first I did here and here, put all my sequins in, and then I sealed the whole thing. The back page is just sequins. I didn't do anything fancy on the back. So let's go into it. This, I guess the recipient can take this off if she wants to, but I didn't make it with the intentions for her to take it off. It's kind of stuck there. So I used a couple different layers and some tulle. I stitched, I used some trim here, a little bit of these enamel dots from Michael's last year, I think they have them this year. I also wanted to use a paper that was quite subtle behind it, so I paired it with that. The first page is, everything is quite simple in here. It's very hard to make a flip book flat if you start adding all these layers. And if you've watched, I like to use layers, but then the flip book doesn't close and it gets so bulky. So you have to keep the layers to a minimum. So I did the pulled paper back here, and then I just taped a pack of those hearts onto the back. And then if you can see here, this paper, I made it so it was part of this page. So the same piece I used here, I used on the back. And this is actually an entire box of the Maggie Holmes little tassels. I decided, instead of making a shaker window, why don't I just make the window with the tassels? She's gonna have to rip this apart to open it. I hate doing that when I get projects, but just rip it apart. Whatever, I made it for you to rip apart. Just tear it apart, don't feel bad. It's just paper, just rip into it and get your goodies. You can probably be careful and like sneak them out over here, but just do it. For this page, I fussy cut all these and raised them so they look like they're popping out like 3D. And again, I still tried to use a lot of layers, but I had to keep it flat. So this I got in a swap some time ago, and it's been floating around in this little jar thing that I keep next to me. I try to clean that thing out once in a while, because otherwise it gets so overwhelming in there, I don't even look in there, because I'm like, I don't even know what's in there. And then I used some little hearts. This is from Target last year. For the next one, oh, there is a pocket here. I don't know if I, maybe I'll put my like note in there and put a little pull tab here. I forgot that I did the pocket. And then here's the last page. So this page I wanted to keep simple. I wanted really you, when you flipped it over, just to see this embellishment. This embellishment, I used this like Tombow comes off and on glue, but I put too much on it because I wanted her to be able to reuse this, but it's just gonna probably rip the doily. She can still rip it off, but I put too much on. I should have just put a little dot and I went like all over the back. So I wanted this to be nice and simple. I did share these embellishments on my Instagram page also. I made 4 or 5 of them, but I use these little, I think these are from Joann's, these little sparkly, like, I don't even know, these rhinestones, flatback rhinestones. And then just added a few little stickers. I backed the paper with some tulle and did stitching around. I always like to add the stitching, even if you don't really see it, because even if you don't realize it's there, it just adds to it. So if you do have a sewing machine, don't be afraid to use it. I did not know how to sew until about a year, maybe a year and a few months ago. And literally I learned so I can sew on paper. So I, trust me, I am not a sewer. My sewing machine is right to the left of me. I pretty much always have it out, but here's it. This is the book. Oh, and I want to tell you about my giveaway. I changed it because there's only like 350 views and you guys are going to wait forever if I wait until 2000 views. So I changed it to just go on until the end of the month. So I will randomly select a winner at the end of the month. So keep commenting. If you want to enter, just go check out my video right before this video. It's called Make It. I already forget. Oh my gosh. Watch it, win it. Wow, Shara. Okay, thank you for watching, everybody. Enter the giveaway. I will end it at the end of the month, and I hope you enjoyed my little flipbook, window-y awesomeness. Bye.